Hello everybody, Sifter again with another modded Peglin run. And today it's not gonna be a run, to be honest. Today it's going to be the billion damage attempt. Not trillion, billion, let's be honest here. And I have searched the land for the fight, and here we are exactly in front of the fight. We wanted the spiral map. Now, with the relics, really quickly going through the relics. Actually, I can go through the relics while this is happening, although it's gonna be a bit laggy. Yeah, look at this craziness. We got Strange Brew for resets and crits also give us damage. We got Abidisciplinarity to be able to discard orbs so we can set up the way we want. We got crits refresh, like who cares. We got resets also crit, like also who cares, but we added them. Pocket Watch, deal extra damage longer in the flight. It's just a constant tick of damage. Spurious Necklace, wall bounces contribute to damage, and also Spacious Necklace ring, bouncers contribute to damage. Those normally are only the damage that the orb does. For example, 3 to 5, it's not going to be 400 something, so it's not going to be that much. Next one is Power Glove, which we have for +1 damage on wall bounces pretty much, because as I said, we don't really care about the bounces and the pegs. The pegs will already do like a million damage, so Power Glove's not really gonna change anything. Lucky Penny, we have 2 more crits, not really that important. 2 more resets is a bit more important. Then we got Monster Training, double damage, which is also obviously insane. Give me a second here. This was already, I think, 11 million. Let's go with the next one. Yeah, as long as they split well, we are good to go. Then we got Gift That Keeps On Giving, so that we can hit every single peg 3 times. I start believing this is not really that good, because what is happening is that some pegs get shielded, like you will see. So sometimes a bunch of things get clumped up in an area, and then when everything in front of it goes down, they fall off. And also there is a negative when my orbs are in the bottom. I'm gonna explain in a moment the relics. We got a bunch of time here. Let's continue. By the way, double damage is active because I'm at low life. That's how this thing works. Then we got Lucky Meteorite to provide explosive force. Then we got Matryoshka Shell, which says +1 level of multiball, but is +8. I tried to do this with +9. So at +8 level of multiball, it means that you do you have 256 orb, I think. And if you have 9 levels of multiball, you have 512 orbs. The difference is huge, because as you saw, the game lagged here. I tried with level 9 Matryoshka. I mean, if you have a better PC, you can do it, but my PC definitely cannot handle it. And then we got Cursed Mask, +2 damage per peg hit. Once again, this is mostly for wall bounces and bouncer bounces, because that +2 damage is really relevant. And then we also got the Electropegnet. I have been suggesting this thing will help. I'm not sure if this helps. So from relics, I'm not sure if Electropegnet and Gift That Keeps On Giving actually help. You know, that's my opinion. Let's go on. Now, for damage numbers, it's easy to understand what's happening. So, the number written here when you hit an enemy can have up to 6 digits in a line, right? So, if it is just one line of numbers, then that means it's in the thousands. It's either 50,000 or 100,000 or 300,000 or, I don't know, 500,000. It could be anything in the thousands. The moment a number gets below, like if you see some amount of numbers at the top and 1 or 2 below, those numbers below indicate that it's a million, right? Because as I said, for some reason in this game, the numbers can have up to 6 numbers. The numbers have numbers. I you know what, let me search this in translate, because I don't know how exactly it is called. I mean, we're lagging here anyway. Okay, digit. Yeah, found the word digit. So as I said, if the number has 2 digits below, so if it's like a 2 lane number, then however many the digits below are, that's how many millions we got. I don't mean that the numbers below are the millions. The numbers below are obviously the small numbers. For example, if the number is, let's say, 666555 32, right, that means that the number is 66,655,000. I don't know how better to explain. For example, if the number is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, right? Because there are three numbers at the bottom, it means that it's 123 million. Like the first three numbers, the phenomenon that the three numbers are below means that the first three numbers are the millions. So what we want to see is four numbers below. Here you saw two numbers below, right? So that means that the number was 78 million, because I think I saw 78 as the first two numbers of the number. It's a bit complex the way I'm explaining it, but I can't really explain it better without editing the video and showing things on the screen. And right now I don't really have that much time free because I'm running around for errands for, you know, holidays. So I'm sorry if I have to explain by randomly saying things, like abstract explaining. But I think it's understood what I said, right? First of all, I think if I pause and then resume, it goes a smidge faster. No, nothing changed. This only works when there are low orbs. For example, if there are 20 orbs left, I can pause and then resume and it will start to speed up a bit more. We're gonna see how this goes. This looks really promising, right? Crit? What is the crit? What do you mean crit? Oh, I guess the resets? I don't even know. This starts speeding up. Okay, now that it's speeding up, I think there are few enough so that we speed. Nope, nothing changed in the end. In the end, nothing really changed with my pausing. Okay, now here I can really explain what I mean with a number. The reason I'm explaining all this is just to be clear and to also have a future plan, quote-unquote, to easily realize what the number is. So we really want to see four numbers below the top six numbers. So this was 89 million pretty much, because I saw the first two numbers were 89 and there were two digits below the first six numbers. So that means it's 89 million. Let's go. No, this is the last enemy. Shit. That's only how many enemies we get. We begin. Let's do this. Split, my children. We lost three orbs, which might mean we lost like more than three. These orbs here might be like 50 orbs. Okay. So this thing hits five times. Theoretically speaking, this should do five times as much damage as the previous shots did, right? Theoretically speaking. Now, practically, that might not be the same, might not be true, but we're gonna see. Let's hope we see four digits at the bottom, or at least let's hope we hit for 500 million, because my high score right now is 208 million. Although I would really, really would like to get a billion. And I'm also thinking about tomorrow shooting a video where I get a trillion, because I think there is a way to get a trillion, but just so you know, it's going to be a meme, right? I'm gonna repeat this in the end again before this video ends, so for anybody that cares. But tomorrow I'm gonna do like a meme video that I will hit a trillion on, because we're modding the game anyway, so might as well mod whatever I want. Anyway, let's continue here. I'm not sure if we're gonna hit the trillion though. Not the trillion, the billion. I'm not sure if we're gonna hit the billion, because it feels like this shoots more orbs down, because the gift that keeps on giving, think of it like this. Let's say like five orbs are here, right? So they all of them hit and peg and make them disappear, right? Because the gift that keeps on giving can only sustain three hits. So if I have like 5 or 10 orbs, they will all hit it really fast and it will disappear. Then they will go below. Okay, they will start dropping, right? And then somewhere along the line, a bunch of other orbs will hit a reset, right? And if I hit a reset while the orbs are below this threshold, like if the orb is down here, then there is no saving it. But if, for example, the reset hits while it's around here, and for example, they might be shooting upwards, the moment the reset hits, it's gonna fling down three orbs. Now, you might say the same goes for above. For example, an orb can maintain itself high on the top for a longer time, for a longer duration. But I'm not sure that actually counts, because the Orbsium, I think, eats through them. I'm not sure. I'm just spitballing here. I just have a running theory, but it does not mean that it's correct. I have no idea how much damage we're doing right now. I mean, this seems to be freezing more than it did last time, I think. We're definitely gonna go above 200 million, right? 200 million is a given, because we already have double damage. So baseline, with the double damage alone, and with the phenomena that we also have wall bouncers, and we also have walls count, bouncers count, we do double damage. These three things alone should already make it more than 200 million, right? And the only way it's not more than 200 million is if actually the gift that keeps on giving or the Magnesis, because I also have those two, do something negative. Because those things are the ones that you don't know if they actually do something negative or positive if you don't play. While the rest obviously are only positive or negative. So you can, I mean, double damage is obviously positive. Plus one damage on pegs, obviously positive. Damage from walls, obviously positive. You can hit each peg 3 times. I'm not really sure. Is it all only positive? Because that also means you are it's harder for you to get to reset, right? Because if a reset is here in the middle, I have to eat through these orbs like 5 to 6 times to be able to hit the reset. That's my main concern. Although I see there is like an orb stuck in here hitting these 3 orbs all the time, but it's gonna definitely disappear. That's also a problem. If orbs did not disappear, then maybe we would be able to get a bunch more damage, because a bunch of orbs actually get stuck inside some of these. And because we actually play with a gift that keeps on giving, they don't pop the pegs fast enough. So make what it does you wish. By the way, this is like us watching this thing be broken and just me speaking, I guess, but I don't care. What will you do in New Year's Eve? Are you ready to see the 1 trillion video? Are you going to go out with friends? I would like to have gone into a ski vacation, but did not actually plan ahead and do it. And also, yeah, I mostly did not plan ahead and do it because I did not know what is going to happen with COVID. Oh, I should not have said this word. No, YouTube demonetization. Well, let's hope we did not get actually hit. And yeah, as I was saying, we're gonna see on the numbers. Yeah, as I said, I do not know what rulings would happen here in my country. So, you know, you can plan a vacation and then boom, nope, you're not allowed to go outside. You're toast. You lose. Good day, sir. Look at these resets. What bad resets. What bad resets. We're closing into the end. We're closing into the end. And I said the bad word. I really hate the fact that there are some words that if you say them, the algorithm is like, oh, ho, 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 we are going to ostracize you. Ostracize? I think ostracize is the word, right? I'm pretty sure ostracize is the word. That means that they throw you out of their community pretty much. I'm not sure how it's said in English. I'm like literally taking the Greek word and just saying it in English. It's like the meme with the French, right? Where you say, let's say in English it's water, and in French it's le water, and it's a meme. So I'm doing the same thing with Greek to English, like, it's ostracized. I don't know how it's normally said. Although, to be honest, it should be ostracize. It should definitely have a K somewhere. Because in Greek it's like exostratizo. So in English, I don't know, exostrakais. I think it's ostracized. Anyway, it does not matter. I digress. Let's hope it doesn't happen to us. I'm filling the void with pandering so that YouTube lets us live. I'm gonna see in the analytics, you know. I'm gonna see in the analytics. Anyway, a reset here is never gonna get hit. This does not look good. Okay, we're back. First of all, this definitely feels like 500 million for sure. So let's hope we see the 4 digits at the bottom. And let's see what happens. Do I have a single 3000 hit orb? I don't think so, right? I have some 2500s. There is like a 2800 here. Here, look at this. 3916 is this orb. 6400 is this one. This is the most hit orb. I like how there is like a heat map of the... Yeah, this is like 4,000. This side is very powerful. This side a bit less. This one is gonna go down the hatch. Right? Okay, maybe Magnesis will save it. Okay, it's still here. Look at this. It's still going left and right. Okay, Magnesis might keep it alive. I like how every single orb has its little story. Still alive. Okay, this guy's the MVP, man. Oh, I see a downwards corner here. It's over. No, it's over. It lost its magic. And this guy's like rushing. I'm first. Off I go. He disappeared. weird. I'm gonna assume that there isn't. If anybody else sees an orb doing some weird stuff, you could comment it. Like, the timestamp and where it is, circa where it is, like bottom left or bottom right, or you know, something. If you see something weird, you could mention it. 3:55 at the 3 o'clock position. 76 miles, not miles, 76 pegs to the right. This is, we're closing in. It's happening. It's happening. How many minutes? 15 minutes. 15 minutes. Wow. Okay. Good thing. Good thing I was not explore. I was not also video shooting the map. Man, I cannot even explain how bad this was with the mapping. It took me like 2 hours to get to this because in the first attempt, I forgot that I have double damage on low life. So half a minute, like half an hour, maybe more down the drain. Now, second attempt, I remember this thing. And because I have confusion, I actually miss the flame and go into a road. And that one road was the specific road that had this map. And boom, that was also last run. So I lost like 1.5 and then another half minute, half an hour to get to this point. So this is like my fourth attempt. No, I think it's the third attempt to get here. I mean, the story indicates the third attempt, but my memory, you should know that my memory is pretty trash. So it might be the fourth attempt. Anyway, it doesn't really matter. Still, a good thing we actually went with only this. And it starts going faster and faster. Faster. And faster. And faster. Faster. I like when the pace takes. I like this feeling of next. 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 I don't want to repeat myself, but I don't know how to explain. It's really fun. By the way, these resets here are in a really, really, really bad spot. What a bad spot. This is why I said that the gift that keeps on giving might be a trap. Because I cannot get to these resets. Look at this. I can, like, I hit this reset and then I cannot get to this. I have to hit a million orbs. And while this is happening, these orbs here are trying to maintain themselves. They are eating up. Nothing is here in the reset area. What the bad... come on, come on, come on. Hit the reset, man. Okay, we got a reset there, but... I mean, some of the good... Now we're just grasping on straws, right? Okay, I think we can escape here and let it speed up. Okay, it's helping. Okay, we hit the reset. It's slowing down again. By the way, the flickering here, do you see the flickering going up and down? Up the dim light and down. Oh, I hate this. Okay, I really don't like it. And I'm pretty sure that everybody that has played Pokemon will agree with me that having indicators that show low life again and again and again and again and again and again, and again is really tiring. Like, okay, I don't want to see this light flicker all the time. It's tiring my eyes. I mean, I don't have any problem. I'm not problem. I don't have any illness or I'm not epileptic or anything, but it's tiring to the eyes. Having dark colors for no reason just appear again and again. It's tiring. But anyway, it doesn't really matter. We're close to this. We're close to it. Let's go. We're so close. I'm gonna escape here. I want the shot to be as clear as possible. Okay, this is still lagging a bit. Okay, it's happening. It's happening. We're closing in. Was it a million? Billion? I'm not sure it was a billion. Let me go back into my own footage and see. Okay, so it was 435 million. Billion, yeah, million. 435 million. Yeah, I mean, that's it. It's not a billion, what to say. I'm not sure if you can hit a billion. I mean, even, let's say I somehow could have had double orbs, right? So, first of all, the number is very logical. Let's begin with the basics. Like, the last number we got... I'm gonna do like an outro here and I'm gonna explain my thought process. First of all, the last time we got this, we got 200 million, right? 208 million. So today we got 435 billion, million again. Double damage, if we take the last indication as anything, double damage should bring us from 208 million up to 416 million, right? Now, the gift that keeps on giving and the Electropegnet, I think, did not do anything. Like, there was no big change. Maybe a small change. Maybe that's the difference from 400 and something to 415, for example, up to 435. Like, maybe the gift that keeps on giving added like 20 million on the number, right? The Power Glove plus the Spurious Necklace plus the Specious Necklace, that might have added a million, maybe 2 million. I mean, I don't think they added so much, but they might have. they might have, maybe even 5 million, you know, but definitely more, not more than the rest. Because you have to think about like this. Each peg hit gave us 5 times, right? 5 times, 400, 4,000. So I hit the peg once, boom, 20,000 for one peg hit, 20,000, okay? And then if I hit a wall, it's par glove, 1 damage. This here, 2 damage. And another 2 damage from the cursed mask, 4 damage. And because we're at crit, it's 5 damage. So 5 damage, right? Once. This thing that does only work on pegs. I know this for a fact. I have tested it. So Orbsium hits a wall, 5 damage. Hits a peg, 20k. So this, and this did really not contribute that much. This thing definitely did all the work. So, because, I mean, it's almost a fact, right? From 200 million, we got 435 million. So, it's the numbers are so close to each other that it makes perfect sense. We just have double damage and we did exactly the same amount plus a little bit more because of the gift that keeps on giving and the electro pegging, most likely. And maybe even the strange brew, you know, because we have 3 resets and those 3 resets all the time did 0 damage normally. Now they actually do 20,000 damage. So, I'm not sure about this though, because I think if I hit a reset, the first one counts as 0 and then the next 4 actually count with this. So I might be even wrong about it. So yeah, I think that's it. That's the max we can achieve. You could achieve 500 million. You could achieve 500 million, but it's not really that easy, right? It will take some attempts. It's not going to be that easy. But as I said, because tomorrow I'm going to do a video, I have like an idea in my mind. But it might not work. If it's not gonna work, then tomorrow I'm most likely gonna do a vanilla run or something. But if it works, and it's a big if, then tomorrow I will try to achieve 1 trillion. Once again, it's a meme. It's going to be a meme. So don't come along and say, Yosef, cheat or whatnot. But you will see. You will see. New Year's Eve, we're gonna have a video that's like a trillion just for the meme of it. Just to hit the number and be happy. And, you know, because the last time I did the editing mistake and I was saying trillion, trillion, trillion while I meant billion, billion, billion. While the actual number was million. So yeah, I'm gonna do a meme video tomorrow for hitting a trillion. It's not gonna be a big one. Don't expect something insanely funny or insanely huge. I'm hyping it up a bit more than it needs to be. But when you're gonna see it, you're gonna be like, yeah, I don't know what I was expecting, but that is actually what he said he was gonna do. So also makes sense because he said he doesn't have much time with the holidays and all. Anyway, I think that's going to be it for today. I hope you guys enjoyed. I definitely did. I mean, the PC lagged a bit. Oh, I also, before I end this, I wanted to say, still on the damage number, because I was talking about 435. So, if you have like a super mega PC, a super duper mega PC, and somehow can have Matroska level 9, so instead of having 256, I think, I don't remember the exact number, like, about, instead of having about 250 orbs, you have about 500 orbs, like the double. I'm saying about, you know, it is going to be actually less than the normal number because some are going to fly off the screen right away, so you're going to lose some. So instead of having 250 orbs, you have 500 orbs, right? Still, you should not be able to achieve the billion. No, you should be able. Cancel. Forget it. You will be able. If you have double orbs, you will be able to hit the billion. The reason for that is because the buff orb, the one that actually upgrades the other orbs, that's the main reason, right? You're not gonna get a billion because the Orbsium is gonna be 500. You're gonna get a million because just having double the orbs means double the damage, right? But having double the orbs of the other ones, the one that buff the pegs, that is making a difference. So if these pegs actually, instead of doing 4,000, they do 8,000, and then instead of having 250, you have 500 Orbsiums, then yes, then it's like 4 times the number, then you should achieve about a million and a half, like 1.5 billion, billion. But my PC cannot handle it, I'm sorry. So tomorrow I'm gonna do, as I said, the meme, the modded, the trillion. Maybe even the quadrillion, I'm gonna see. Anyway, that's going to be it for today. Once again, thanks for watching, and see you guys around.